Welcome to the Sophistic Online Documentation. The following video focuses on the superposition of the load actions and on the story checks in the scope of the seismic analysis. Export of the model from Revit to SSD and the calculation of the static loads was previously done with the help of Analysis and Design for Revit 2022. Furthermore, the task Earthquake RSA Reloaded was used to carry out the response spectrum analysis. We'll proceed now with the superpositioning of the actions present in the model. In the Find Combinations task, combination rules according to the selected code will be automatically generated and shown in the Sophistic Superposition Manager. ULS fundamental combination will be used later on for the shear wall design and capacity check for building course. Main interest of this video is the ULS seismic combination. All the action types available in the project are automatically included in the seismic combination rule. We already defined the sophistic load actions with the help of Analysis and Design for Revit 2022. Seismic action E will be automatically created after calculating the earthquake RSA task, or it can be added to the action manager beforehand. For more information, please check the README task added to the tutorial. In the superpositioning task, the superposition commands can be selected for the previously defined combination rules. Focus here is on the superpositioning results from the ULS seismic combination needed for the story checks, mainly the story forces, interstory drifts, and story displacements. They will be saved starting from the corresponding load case number and calculated by clicking OK. We'll proceed now with the story checks task. The task offers multiple story design seismic checks to quickly reveal the problematic parts in the layout of the structure and to identify whether a redesign may be required. The General tab provides a tabular and an interactive graphical overview of all the previously defined stories in the project. The Synopsis table contains the information about the story's designation, elevation, and height. We can click through the rows or mark multiple stories, and the viewer will then correspondingly highlight our selection. Furthermore, the information about the position of the center of mass and the center of rigidity for each story is available in the following table. By hovering the mouse cursor over the column header titles, additional information will be offered in the form of a tooltip. The viewer also marks the position of the centers of mass for each story. The story selection offers an additional filtering option. In this way, only the stories defined between the following range will be displayed in the later generated story check tables. We will select here all the stories above the ground level. The Checks tab offers a selection of two design codes and an overview of all the available story checks. More information about the supported design codes and the checks in general can be found online by pressing F1 or clicking the Help button. And proceeding to the Theoretical Principles section. In this example, we will proceed with the default Eurocode design code selection. The story checks can be divided into regularity checks and advanced or load-dependent checks. Regularity checks, namely the soft and weak story check, can be used to examine the regularity of story stiffness, mass, and shear capacity along the height of the building. Both checks require a specification of thresholds, which are used to determine the boundaries of the regularity ranges. For example, the ratio of the story stiffness to the story stiffness above and to the average stiffness of three stories above will be calculated with the soft story check. Finally, these values are then compared to the ranges extreme soft, soft, and regular range. Similar approach is used for the regularity checks involving mass and shear capacity. The shear capacity calculation requires an additional specification of the maximum concrete and steel shear stresses, which will be multiplied with the corresponding story's concrete and steel shear areas. Each selected check will generate a separate tab in the task with all the needed result tables and plots. They will be automatically calculated in the background, allowing for an interactive post-processing. Therefore, switching between the task and the report document while varying the check parameters is not needed. We will keep the task's default values here and proceed to the weak story check tab. We can notice here two tables with the information about the shear capacity and the shear capacity ratio for all the selected stories in both X and Y direction. These tabular values are also graphically depicted in the following two plot areas. Additionally, the green area in the shear capacity ratio plot represents the regular range for the weak story check. We will zoom out here to show the other ranges determined with the previously mentioned thresholds. Shear capacity ratios in X and Y direction are all in the regular range, and the same check results can be also found in the tables. We can also observe here a significant decrease in the shear capacity between the 19th and the 20th story. We can examine this in the table by selecting the corresponding table rows. This automatically highlights the points in both of the plots. We will check the cause of this jump by going back to the General tab and highlighting the before mentioned floors. As it can be seen here, the significant change in the floor layout causes decrease of the shear concrete area. The advanced checks, which can be activated with the following selection, are load-dependent checks. They require a load case selection for the total gravity load used for the second order check and the shear forces. We selected here the load case containing the minimum total vertical story forces as a superpositioning result from the seismic design combination. Furthermore, selection of the load cases for design is also required. Story drifts, shear forces, and/or displacements will be taken from these load cases and used for the advanced checks. We chose here the superpositioning results from the seismic design combination, which were calculated previously with the superpositioning task. Shared parameters, in the case of the Eurocode design code selection, contain only the displacement behavior factor, which will be used as a multiplication factor for the story drifts and displacements. Following four advanced checks are available. Second order check will calculate the sensitivity coefficient and compare it to the ranges determined according to the here specified thresholds. Drift check will calculate the drift ratio containing the behavior and the reduction factor and determine if it falls below the specified threshold. The check also contains the option to consider the story drifts calculated either in reference to the center of mass or the maximum drifts. Shear forces and displacements will generate tables and plots containing these values along the height of the building. If the second order check shows that the sensitivity coefficient falls between the first and the second threshold in the so-called simplified TH2 range, the option to multiply the story drifts, shear forces, and/or displacements with an automatically determined P delta factor is also available. We will check now the second order check results in the corresponding tab. Generated table contains the calculated sensitivity coefficients for all the selected stories and the corresponding check results. We can see here that all the sensitivity coefficients are below the first threshold and that the check was fulfilled. Only the decisive load cases for each story will be shown in the table generated by the task. Likewise, the plot area displays only two decisive load cases, including the check ranges, which can be fully visualized by zooming out and panning the view. Finally, the Output tab offers the possibility to change the extent of the report generated by the task. For example, if all the selected design load cases for any of the advanced checks needs to be printed, or the possibility to turn off the plots. We will generate the report by clicking the OK button. Similar to the task, the report contains the information about the tables and plots for every selected check, with the additional information in the table's legends. This is the end of the video. Thank you for your attention.